There's no way, right? Is it possible that playing virtual reality, wearing VR, can keep your eyes from getting more nearsighted, can keep your vision from getting worse? I mean, there's no way, right? No, right? Right? Or maybe. I feel like I'm constantly diving into the research, anything regarding VR, virtual reality, and how it affects the eyes, whether it's a vision, binocular vision, dry eyes, anything. And so I came across a study a while ago, and it completely surprised me. This study was designed to measure for any ocular effects from playing VR. This ranged from binocular vision, eye turns, eye posture, focusing, accommodation, and one other thing to see if there could be any possible long-term effects to increase myopia or increase nearsightedness after playing VR. Now, first off, a little bit about myopia. They're pretty much classifying it as an epidemic, with projections of around 50% of the population will be nearsighted by the year 2050. We're pretty much seeing a crazy rise in nearsightedness in the population. And because of this, there is a lot of research and studies going into the possible causes and treatments that we could do to potentially slow myopia down. And more recent studies are showing, hey, some of the best things that you can do is get off our screens, get off our tablets, our computers, and get outside. Focus on something far away, get some natural light. So for the design of this study, they took a group of young adults, 18 to 35 years old, men and women. They all had similar lower prescriptions, and they tested them before and after certain sessions of playing in virtual reality. They tested for binocular vision, they tested their visual acuity, fixation, and accommodation, their focusing, and one big thing was their choroidal thickness. Now, I know what you're thinking, what is that? Now, I'm going to explain, but just a warning, we're gonna get a little scientific, a little bit nerdy, but I promise it's gonna make sense at the end. The choroid is the middle layer of the wall of the eye, sandwiched between the sclera, the white part of the eye, and the inner layer, the retina, with all the light cells that allows you to see. And the choroid is mostly and mainly made up of all blood vessels. And the reason why the choroid is being measured more often these days is because it has been linked to myopia progression. As people get more nearsighted, their eyeballs get longer, and the choroid gets thinner. And that was the main thing that they were looking for in the study, to see if the choroid got thinner after playing VR. Okay, we're gonna go over the results to the study and what they mean. As far as binocular vision, fixation, accommodation, they actually didn't find any significant difference before they played VR and after, meaning it didn't really have a long-lasting effect. And that's even with the participants dealing with the vergence accommodation conflict that is commonly found when using virtual reality. Usually in real life, the eye muscles that converge and diverge our eyes are usually linked with the focusing muscles of the eyes. They kind of work in harmony together. When you look far away, our eye muscles will diverge and our focusing muscle relaxes so we can see and make it a single image. When we look at something close up, our eye muscles will converge, go closer together, and our focusing muscles will flex so we can have a single and clear image. In VR, we actually have a conflict between those two systems because the focal point in VR is set at one plane. We don't need to relax or flex our focusing muscles, but we still need to diverge and converge to make it a single image. So even if there were binocular issues or accommodation issues, they resolved by the time that they could test their eyes after each session of playing VR. Now here's the interesting point, and this is the part that surprised me. They measured choroidal thickness and found that it actually got thicker when they thought it would get thinner. Let me explain. Now in the real world, your eyes want to focus all the light to the back of the eye, the macula. That's what will make things really clear. Now, when you go to look at something up close, there's a little bit of a lag in that focus. Your eyes actually have to adapt for it. When you go to look up close, the eyes actually focus the light behind the eye, causing a little bit of a defocus. And so then your eye muscles, your focusing muscles, have to adapt and adjust and flex in order to bring that light back to the back of your eye. Now, what's interesting in virtual reality, because of this vergence accommodation conflict, it actually happens the opposite. Now, when you go to look at something up close in VR, your eyes will converge to point at that object, and that will naturally stimulate the focusing muscles to flex. Now, this will cause a defocus of light in the front of the macula, whereas in the normal world, it's usually in the back of the macula. Because the focal distance is further out in the distance, your eyes have to figure out, hey, you need to relax. You need to relax your focusing muscle. So it relaxes and adjusts the focus of the light back to the macula. And they theorize that's the reason why they found that the choroid actually got thicker instead of thinner, because it's the opposite in virtual reality. And that was actually the only difference that they found in this whole study. Okay, so that being said, welcome to the world of research. Research and eyes, where one research might say, hey, this is right, and then another research says, nope, that's not right. There was another study done later on that didn't really find any thickening of the choroid. Now, both of these studies were designed different, so which one's right? In fact, they need to have more studies to really find out if this is a thing. So I think we need to take these studies with a grain of salt. There are some holes to this study. The participants only did 40-minute sessions. I'd be curious to see more long-term sessions, like 2 hours per session. That's usually what a lot of people do when they're playing VR, maybe even more. Another one, all the participants were young adults older than 18. I think it would be beneficial if they could study more younger generation, younger population, teenagers, maybe kids, to see if this has the potential to act as a myopia control, maybe slow the progression of myopia down. And I think they needed more participants in the study to get a more broader picture. And they acknowledged this in the study, saying, hey, we were not expecting this to find this in this study. We were thinking that there was going to be some thinning of the choroid. And so they said, hey, we have some holes in this study, and we really need to design a study with more people, younger population, going forward to really see if this is the thing. So let me get this straight. I'm definitely not saying that playing VR is going to keep you from getting nearsighted. So don't take that from this video. It's just interesting what they're finding in the studies, and hopefully they can study it a little bit more to see if that is actually a potential to playing VR, that it could have a benefit. We'll see. So is it possible that virtual reality wearing VR could slow down the progression of myopia, keep your vision from getting worse? My hunch is still no, but studies like this definitely makes me wonder and think about it. What do you think? Stay focused.